Hello everyone, once again welcome back in my class. I am your mentor Nisha and today I have brought one more new chapter for you. And this chapter is quite interesting, as we all know that the chapter's topic is transport and communication. But actually thing is that this chapter is little lengthy. So we will be completing this chapter in two different parts. Fine, because two different topics are included. First is transport and second is communication. So transport is different topic and communication is different topic. So two topics we will be completing in one chapter, but we will complete both this topic in little detail. You must be remembering that you have studied this topic in class 3 regarding about transport and communication, but that time you have studied in very short and in very brief way. But as you are in class 5th, you will be studying this chapter in a broader way. So we will be studying this chapter in a deeper way. Now see that the first topic which I am going to start, it is transport. See beta, before connecting to the current transport system near around us, or the what the facilities we are getting regarding the transport, I would like to take you to the ancient time. At the time when people had nothing as a means of transport, how did they do? How did they manage their life? Because us time is life chali rahi thi. Wo bhi aana jana kahin na kahin kar rahe the. They were not means confined at one place. Their life also moved in that time, and still we are moving very rapidly, even more faster than ever before. So how was the means of transport? What was there for their proper transport? Fine. Well, story is that in ancient time, the ancient people, they used to move on their foot. Fine, they used to walk, and the journey what was completed by them, that was only dependent on their two foot. Fine, so the first early human walked on foot, so their journey was long, and as they had no means of transport, that made their journey more longer. Fine. So as they had no means of transport, they used to walk on the foot, means continuously walking. For short journey still we are walking on the foot, but for long journey we have different. So as they used to complete their journey on their foot. In olden time, slowly changes came. So what was the changes? Actually, invention of wheel. One of the most revolutionary changes which took place in their life, it was the invention of wheel. Yes, and the invention of wheel, it was a sudden idea which hit in their mind. Whose mind? Early men's mind. Like a rolling log of wood that kept rolling. Accidentally it was rolling. So that rolling of wooden log, that made the hit in the mind of early human to do something new. So that rolling created the reason, the invention of wheel. And when the wheel was invented, this invention made their life very easy, because the rolling wheel was very faster and it was very useful to drag anything, to carry any load. And slowly this wheel was attached with a cart, and the cart was dragged by an animal. And animals were ox, horse, camels. These were the animals useful to drag the cart. Fine. So firstly they walked on the foot. Second, the invention of wheel, and after invention of wheel, it was dragged by the animals. Fine. And third one is invention of steam engine. Like before invention of steam engine, when these cart were prepared, then people used to sit inside the cart and it was drawn by the animals. So animals were supposed to carry the load of the people and the luggage also. That made their life very easier rather than walking on the foot. And when steam engine was invented, it was another turning point, means sudden a turning point when the steam engine was invented. It was invented by James Watt, and steam engine was one of the revolutionary changes, changing time, and it created the locomotive transport very easy. And this was the turning point which carry numbers of people at a one time. And people started to travel from one place to another place after the successful invention of steam engine. Fine, because it was quite difficult to carry numbers of people at the same time at from by a same system. Fine. So third one part is mode of transport. Now, by how many modes we do transport, means how do we travel? What are the different ways by which we travel? We are not restricted by one type of transport. Like we are having three different means of transport. We are traveling by land on road surface. We are traveling by airways. We are traveling on water surface too. So there are three different means of transport. It is land, air and water. And for these three different means of transport, we have different kinds of vehicles, and these are supposed to be related with a particular way of transport. Like suppose we have, so beta, for different means of transport we have different vehicles. Suppose for if we say that bus, if we suppose a bus to fly in the air, it is quite impossible. And if we suppose an airplane to walk on the surface of the water, it is impossible, it cannot happen. So each and every vehicle has been designed according to the relative surface. So bus has been designed to walk on a proper hard surface, it is land surface. And planes are there which are supposed to fly in the air, and the sheep, boat, rat, trees are some vehicles which are supposed to walk on the water surface. Now, as we know that there are three different means of transport: land transport, air transport and water transport. So land transport, this is called roadways; air transport, airways; and water transport, it is called waterways. So when we talk about the roadways, then we must know that how many types of roads do we have. Like roads are mainly of two types: kaccha road and pakka road. In class 3 you have read about kaccha road and pakka road. Actually beta, the word kaccha means raw, which is not completely prepared. So the kaccha road is mean like the road which is made up of mud, straw and wet soil. So these kind of road are not good for heavy vehicles, because heavy vehicles, if running on the kaccha road, it can break the road and it can insert deep inside the soil. So it is very problematic to come out of the wet soil or the kaccha road. Now kaccha road is mainly found in rural areas, in village area. And next we talk about pakka road. Pakka road means ki that concrete cemented road which is very hard in surface and heavy vehicles can run on it easily. Fine. Next is railways. So railways is one of the road transport, and railways means that the proper rail line, railway track is there, proper track is there on which rail is running. Fine. And railways are again of different types: the tram, the metro rail and the common railways. So railway is one of the cheapest mode of transport, because it was one of the transport which was invented before any other means of transport. Fine. First train ran between Thane and Mumbai. The first train which was started in the year 1853, which was firstly ran between Thane to Mumbai. It is the part of Maharashtra. And next is passenger train, good train, metro train and trams. These are again types of railways. Passenger trains means ki those trains commonly which are running carrying passengers, numbers of passengers at one time. Second is goods train, jisko hum Hindi mein maal gaadi kehte hain, hai na? Goods train means ki that train which is carrying numbers of goods with it. Fine. Next is metro train. Metro train is that train which is running under the tunnel of the deeper section of the soil. The special tunnel is designed where train is passing. Fine. So that some trains are running on the surface of the soil and some trains which is running under the surface of the soil. And next is tram. Tram is mainly found in Kolkata, yes, city of joy. Tram. So tram are not found anywhere in all part of the India. In some part it is found, but mainly it is found in Kolkata and still it is running. So this is all about the railways. Now let's we talk about the railway system. Different kind of rail network. See beta, the United States of America, USA. Fine, which part of the world? USA, United States of America. It has largest rail network. It means the rail network throughout this place is one of the largest network of railways in the world. Means most of the transport and the traveling of people is carried by only railway network. Fine. Next is India has fourth largest network in the world. It means ki India ek aisa country hai jahan jo fourth ranking par hai for its rail connection. Fine. It is one of the fourth largest network in the world for its railways, and you know that it is one of the cheapest means of transport comparing to other means of transport. The Gotthard Base Tunnel in Switzerland. Yes, it is the tunnel. Tunnel means that just a few minutes back I have told you that for passage of metro train, it is all done under the surface of the soil. So a very long tunnel is dug so that the metro train can pass easily. Fine. So this is called the word tunnel, and one of the largest, longest tunnel in Switzerland, and its name is the Gotthard Base Tunnel. Where it is constructed? It is constructed in Switzerland. Okay. Next is waterways. So railways I have explained, so I hope you have understood. Next we talk about waterways. After the invention of steam engine, ship started running on diesel. But before starting this topic, I want to tell you that what is waterways actually. Waterways is one of the means of transport, and it is the means of transport which is used by the people, and ship, boat or raft is used to carry people, to carry loads, and long, very huge cargoes are also supposed to run on the waterways. And these are the means of transport which is commonly used by the people since ancient time to till now. Now ships has been modified. Now ships are very advanced. These ships are fit, are having steam engines also, so that the human labor is not much required. Fine, very less human efforts are required because steam engine is fit with these ship or cargoes, so that these waterways can carry long. So waterways is one of the important means of transport. And beta, it does not mean that in means of transport whatever new technologies has come, so we are forgetting the old one. No, old one is still existing but with little advancement. Fine. So you see that waterways, after invention of steam engine, and in the previous topic I have told you that steam engine, it was invented by James Watt, and ship started running on diesel. Actually in olden times ships were drawn by the human labors. They were pulled by the human labor, and in olden times prisoners, they were punished to drag the ship by putting their labors, but as a punishment they were given such a punishment. But nowadays, like steam engine which was invented after the invention of steam engine, it was fit in the cargoes and big ships. So the all human labor which was supposed to drag the ship and the vehicles, waterways, that was stopped, and this steam engine used so that it is automatically or technically being pulled. Fine. Next is ports. Before starting about ports, that how many ports are there in India, I want to tell you that what is port. Actually beta, like for buses there is a bus stop, for airplanes there is an airport. So similarly for all ships and cargoes, there is a proper place which is used for the maintenance or the stay of these vehicles, and it is the huge and large place where ships, cargoes and these water systems are taking place. These are cleaned, these are maintained, loads are carried and loads are पुट डाउन फ्रॉम दीज व्हीकल्स। सामान इनमें डाला जाता है, दूसरी कंट्री में भेजा जाता है और दूसरी कंट्री से आया हुआ सामान यहाँ पर अनलोड होता है। सो लोडिंग एंड अनलोडिंग ऑफ गुड्स कीप कंटिन्यूड वेयर, नॉट ऑन द मिडल ऑफ द वाटरवेज, एग्जैक्टली देयर इज अ प्रॉपर प्लेस वेयर दीज थिंग्स आर लोडेड एंड अनलोडेड। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द पोर्ट एंड इन इंडिया यू नो हाउ मेनी पोर्ट्स आर देयर, देयर आर मेनली 13 पोर्ट्स, यस 13 major ports are there in India. Fine. So, the Suez Canal. Yes. Canal means ki a very long way. The Suez Canal, it is the joining part which was created in 1869. Okay. Next is the Panama Canal. Long way, not like it is a canal. Canal means that a waterways or a seaways. Okay, don't think that it is a long way. It is a canal. Canal means ki a part of the waterways which is joining two different parts. So now you see the Panama Canal. It is one of the most famous canal in the world, and it is joining Pacific and Atlantic Ocean. The Pacific Ocean and the Atlantic Ocean, the joining part between these two is called Panama Canal. Fine. Now next is waterways are again of two types. Fine. First is inland waterways and second is oceanic waterways. So inland waterways includes rivers, canal and backwaters. Fine means in within. Next is oceanic means ki at a large mass of waterways. It includes sea and ocean. Fine. The transport between sea and ocean. So this is all about waterways, which I have told you that waterways are again of different type, and waterways are equally very important like the roadways, the airways and so on. Now let's we talk about third means of transport, and it is very interesting, yes, because it is one of the expensive and fastest means of transport. Air transport I am talking about, and it was invented in the year 1903. Yes, in the year 1903 first airplane was invented by Wilbur Wright and Orville Wright. Wright brothers, they are famous. This is the name Wright brothers. So who were Wright brothers and for what they are famous? Wright brothers were two brothers. Their name was Orville Wright and Wilbur Wright, and they were famous because they invented the first airplane in the year 1903. Okay, and first plane which was invented by them, it was named Flyer. So if you are asked that what was the name of the first airplane, so you have to write a name, Flyer. Yes, Flyer was the first airplane invented by Wright brothers. Next is airport. What is airport? Airport is that huge part where airplanes are landing and taking off, and it is the place where these are maintained. And airplanes are again of two different types, domestic airplanes and international airplanes. Domestic airplanes means ki those airplanes which is flying within the country, within own country, fine, one state to another state. And international airplanes means ki those airplanes which are flying from one country to another country, means country to country they are flying for. So this is two different kinds of flights I have told you. Now it is very important means of transport, as it is very helpful. Why it is so helpful? Because at the time of natural crisis or any tragedy, at the time of emergency, airplanes or air transport is that means of transport which is coming forward or which is very fastest to provide help to the people who are in any problem. Suppose if there is any natural disaster at the time of any famine, at the time of any flood, what is happening? People require immediate help. So for immediate help, we cannot provide the help to the people by traveling through railways, roadways or waterways, because these are slow mediums of transport. For their immediate help, we need air transport so that it can provide the help to the people at very fast space. Fine. So, and the last point is fastest and expensive modes of transport. Yes, it is quite clear that air transport is one of the fastest transport. Within very few time, limited time, we can reach to the different part of the country. And it is one of the expensive, yes, because very fine quality of petrol, diesel is fuel is required to fly an airplane. So it is very, very costly. So this is all about the airways. And in this part of this chapter, we have read about complete transport system. It is of three different types. And what are these three different types I have told you? So I think you have understood this chapter. And in next part, I will be coming with the means of communication. So if you have any queries till this part, you can make your queries in the comment box. I will be happy to help you, and surely I will be helping you. So keep waiting for the next part, because I will be coming to complete this chapter with the remaining part, means of communication. Till then, have a nice day.